Sunday evening, everybody. Lord's Day, Sunday evening. Here is your August the 18th and 19th Weekend Devo. Episode 42 of the Turning Point series. Here is your third part of the Season Living series. The Weekend series. Today's topic, we're going to be talking about bitter. And we're going to be beginning with chapter 1, verse 20 of the book of Ruth. And your daily reading, or your recommended reading, what I read from my Bible, is chapter 4 of Ruth, verses 13 to 22. So it's going to be the same book. We're going to start out with 120, and then turn around and read 4, 13 to 22. Your turning point today is from F.B. Meyer, and your weekend reading is the book of Amos. The book of Amos. You might as well say it's the book of Amos, but they say there's nine chapters. Let me look at my Bible and let me look at it just to get a good idea. Where is the book of Amos? There's Obadiah. Okay, that's Amos. Speaking of Amos, that's the name of my uncle, who lives in Georgia. Married to my mother's baby sister, so so that's my uncle. Okay, Amos. First chapter is 15 verses. Second chapter is 16 verses. Third chapter is 5. 13 verses. 5 is 27 verses. That's a longer one. 6 is 14 verses. 7 is 17. 8 is 14. And 15 for chapter 9. So about 15 to 20 verses per chapter. With the one being 27 verses. And then the next day you go to the book of Obadiah, which, it's only one chapter with 21 verses, which you do, if you list verses from Obadiah, you just put Obadiah verse whatever. And that's the same way you do with the book of Jude. You put Obadiah. But basically, if you're reading the whole book, just put the book of Amos. Don't even put the chapters. Because you're going to get in and just read. But they just give you the number. I guess that's the way they have to print it. They have to print it with the numbers. And with the ones with just one chapter, they have to put the one in and get it to print right. So, excuse me. Sorry about that. Just before I started this recording, I took a swallow of my root beer. My A&W root beer. Pretty good. But that's that way. Just wanted to give you a heads up of how long the chapters were. So we're talking about bitter. Beginning with Ruth 1:20, which I've got it on the page. But he said to them, Do not call me Naomi. Call me Mara, for the Almighty has dealt very bitterly with me. And you're speaking about Naomi. I don't remember the story about Naomi and Ruth. And I remember when I was at Word of Life, we done a class where we went through the book of Judges, where we studied the book of Judges, and then we got all the Judges study done. Then they broke into the book of Ruth. And then we did a special like scenario where a bunch of the students got up there and one played this person, one was supposed to be representing this person. But it's pretty neat. And at that time, we had Tom Phillips, which at the time he was the head, the big man on campus, basically the head of Word of Life Florida, which now is Rich Andrews. So he was the assistant at the time Tom Phillips was in there, but Tom moved to New York, done stuff up there at that thing, and then he was called away. God told him he was no longer needed with Word of Life, or Tom felt like he was no longer needed at work with Word of Life, so he moved. He moved down to back to Georgia, North Georgia, where I lived for a little while. And he's in the town of Ringo, which where I started out at when we moved up to North Georgia. In 2003? So I graduated in 99. It was up until 2003. We moved to North Georgia. And we moved to Ringo. Started out living with my aunt before she moved out. And then we moved into an apartment there close to the I-75 interstate. Wasn't too far off from the interstate. We lived there for about a year. Almost a year. Then we found a trailer park just beyond the county line, just down the road in Lafayette. We lived there. And I went I went to Job Corps up in Kentucky and around Mammoth Cave, and went up there for like 6 months to come back. We had moved on into town, into Lafayette Town, and we lived there for a while. I think the economy kind of faltered. My dad lost his job, and we couldn't pay any more on our house we were buying. And then my mother made the decision, we're coming back to Florida. And here we are in Florida. I wanted to go back to where I went to high school at, Dublin. In East Dublin, East Lawrence High School, but that didn't work. My mother wouldn't let me. But it is what it is. But now I'm hoping to get moved out by myself and go to Nashville, become a singer. So just pray that that'll happen. But let me stop rambling on. So, but your recommended reading is Ruth 13:20-22. I just happen to have my Bible sitting here ready to go. I already got it set for 13-22, which is the last. This is the descendants of Boaz and Ruth. That's just who we're going to be talking about. So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife. And when he went into her, the Lord gave her conception, and she bore a son. Then the women said to Naomi, "Blessed be the Lord who has not left you this day without a close relative, and made his name be famous in Israel, and may he be to you a restorer of life and a nourisher of your old age, for your daughter-in-law who loves you, who is better to you than seven sons, has borne him." And Naomi took the child and laid him on her bosom and became a nurse to him. Also the neighbor women gave him a name, saying, There is a son born to Naomi. And they called his name Obed. He is the father of Jesse, who is the father of David. Now this is the genealogy of Perez. Perez begot Hezron. Hezron begot Ram. Ram begot Amminadab. I'm a dad that begot Nashon. Excuse me, can't see it. Nashon begot Salmon. Salmon begot Boaz, but Boaz begot Obed. Obed begot Jesse, and Jesse begot David. So it started from Perez and ended up to David. That was the timeline. So there you hear. You heard Obed, Jesse, then David. That was the timeline. David, King David. That's that. So it says, some people avoid bitter flavors, but nutritionists tell us many bitter foods are excellent for our health. Bitter melon, for example, is a cucumber-shaped melon that tastes very bitter, but it's packed with phytochemicals and antioxidants. Cranberries are tart and bitter, but they can reduce inflammation, blood sugar, blood pressure, stomach infection, and tooth decay. Apple cider vinegar is also an elixir for health. So we all have those bitter moments in life, but God has a remarkable way of using them for our spiritual and emotional well-beings. The opening scene of the short Old Testament book of Ruth described the grief and hardship that befell Naomi. She wanted to change her name to Mara, which means bitter, but throughout the book, God worked in providential ways for her and her daughter-in-law, Ruth. And by the end of the story, Naomi was one of the happiest grandmothers in the Bible. Her life was filled with the mature blessings of God. Amen. So Charles Spurgeon said, God not only takes away the bitterness and gives sweetness in its place, but turns the bitterness into sweetness itself. Amen. Today's turning point is from F.B. Meyer, M-E-Y-E-R, which says, as we pour out our bitterness, God pours in His peace. Amen. So I hope you enjoyed that take on bitter and the story about Naomi and her daughter-in-law, Ruth. And in the timeline, so Ruth would be, you look at Ruth as the grandmother of David. And then Ruth was, I believe Ruth was supposed to be some, like, I think she started out like a prostitute. I think she was supposed to be a harlot, prostitute type person, but then she turned her life. God changed her life, and she's the grandmother of David, King David. Yes, that's right. So, but coming up tomorrow in your Monday, your fantastic Monday, September 20th, 2021. Hey, It's gonna be 9/20/21. Write that down. Look at it. It's gonna be 2021, day 20, year 21, and put the slash in there and look at it. 9/20/21, and it looks like you're saying September 2021 or 2021. We're up on the 20th again, people. But it'll be episode 480. Three this time. Last time, in this morning's video, I started out saying 483, and was mistaken. I had to stop, get the right number, and it was supposed to be 482. So this will be 483. I'm gonna have a regular Devo for tomorrow's video. But we're gonna be talking about confidence in Christ alone. We're going to begin with Philippians chapter 3, verses 7 and 8. So we're doing, I guess we're doing a run on Philippians chapter 3 now. Because I have looked up further in the book, and there's several passages from chapter 3. So, basically, we're doing a bunch of chapter 3 of Philippians instead of chapter 2 like we did in the last book. But with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry for the little bit longer than this morning's video. But I got talking about something and started rambling on it. And sometimes when I get talking on something, I'll start stretching it and I forget I'm recording. So I try to keep them as short as possible, but keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day Sunday evening. And come back tomorrow for another fantastic Monday. Woohoo! Woohoo! Goodbye.